Hey, what's up? Welcome back. It's Xander Douik with a new, quick and simple tutorial on how to create realistic camera shake in less than 1 minute. And also, I'm going to show you how to create a camera shake preset so you don't need to go through all these steps anymore. Just drag and drop and you're good to go. Okay, so this is the clip I'm gonna add the camera shake to. So, first of all, create a new adjustment layer, then search for the transform effect and apply it to the adjustment layer. And now, we're gonna animate the position by adding a wiggle expression, which contains two parameters. So, alt-click on the position stopwatch and type in wiggle, open bracket, and type in the first value, which is the frequency. So, let's say 11, it means 11 times per second. And the second value is the amplitude. Let's type in 50, which means 50 pixels for position on 11 times per second. And of course, don't forget to separate both values with a comma, and now close bracket. Now, as you can see, it creates these movements that mimic camera shakes. Okay, so to control these movements, we will use another effect called slider control. This effect does absolutely nothing by itself, but paired with the right effect, it becomes effective. That's why we're going to parent it to the amplitude of the wiggle expression. So select this value, then come here to the pick whip tool and drag it all the way to the slider value. And now we can control it using this slider. So I'm going to add a keyframe just before the hit, then move forward a couple of frames and add another keyframe. And here you want to increase the slider value to, let's say, around 80. Then move forward to when you want the shaking to stop and add another keyframe and lower the value back to 0. So you end up with this look. Now there is one more thing that we need to fix, which is these black edges caused by the movements of the layer. So it's easy to get rid of. Just search for the motion tile effect and apply it to your layer. Check mirror edges, then increase the output height and width values, and that's it. It's so simple. By the way, if you feel that the shake isn't strong enough, you can always go back to this middle frame and increase the amplitude to, let's say, 120 and see how it looks. It's more powerful now. Well, it depends on your shot. And finally, what you can do is just select all these effects and drag them to the Effects and Presets tab to create your own camera shake preset. So the next time you want to add camera shake to your footage, you won't have to go through all these steps. Just type in camera shake, then drag and drop it, and you will only need to add the keyframes. And that's it. Thank you guys for watching. I hope this video wasn't too long. All I wanted is to show you how to create these camera shakes because we will need it a lot in our future tutorials. And quick reminder, the second part of how to create anime VFX videos will be released this week, hopefully, and that's everything. So, see you guys in the next tutorial. Your hands are planned, your own hands can land your own brand, and damn, I feel like no one takes accountability. They want the credibility, convincingly unwilling to put in the hours it takes to get some power. Don't be f***ing sour, take a cold shower.